Welcome and bienvenue to MUAC Jazz Day 2021 edition from Paris, France. Our theme this year is Let's Build a Culture of Peace, Let's Change the Era, or in French, Construisons une culture de la paix, changeons d'air. Why such a theme? We chose it because our world order has too long danced to the rhythm of a war and violence culture, what we could call hard power. And so our question is, why not use this precious moment of global crises to change the foundation? Why not construct the culture of peace and replace the old one once and for all? We'll never find a better opportunity than now, so let's all explore this together. Tonight, Friday, April 2nd, we launch our 2021 Jazz Day events with exceptional musicians from Lille, France. They are composed of two groups, both founded by composer and pianist Stéphane Orens. First, you'll see an intro of Stéphane speaking in French about his three compositions. First up is Humanity, with vocals and very pertinent lyrics in English by Karine Gobert, performed by the Ten Worlds Group, which also includes Stéphane behind the piano, François Taillefer on percussion and vocals, and Pascal Lauvergne on bass. The video immediately following is the Stéphane Orens jazz trio with Stéphane on piano, his brother Peter Orens as drummer, and Christophe Asch on contrabass. They'll perform Pétales au Vent, named after a compilation of poems in homage of its author, Daisaku Ikeda, and Wangari Maathai, in homage of the Kenyan female Nobel Peace Prize laureate of 2004. We are indeed truly fortunate to start our 2021 Jazz Day conference with this exceptional assembly of brilliant and dedicated musicians who played together for almost 25 years. Then for the next week, in an April 9th presentation in our series of five events, Martine Levy-Guggenheim will remind us of UNESCO's constitution, which states in its preamble, "Since wars begin in the minds of men, it is in the minds of men that the defenses of peace must be constructed. Clearly, we created wars, we can stop them." Martine will give us a realistic, yet somehow also optimistic historical overview of modern times efforts, particularly on the level of international institutions, aiming at this project of creating peace cultures, beginning already in the 19th century, she notes. Although her presentation is in French, two posts immediately after her video will have the transcription of her talk, then a translation into English. That same evening of April 9th, Michel Pichon, aka Pichmi, and his Guinean friend Karamba Diobaté, incarnating the 13th century Mandingo Charter for Human Rights by virtue of his role as a griot, will inspire us with the fact that the concept of a peace culture already existed long ago on the African continent. Now to the week of April 16th. Possibilities of humanistic education with music and the arts for teaching human rights, the spirit of global citizenship and respect for nature, will be presented in our April 16th event with Pedro Aledo and musician friends. You'll witness concrete actions, passion, conviction, and inspiring moments with young people of seven countries. Considerando in Spanish, French, and some Italian, a presentation by Pedro in French, and his human hymn in an all-French version. Next, moving to the 23rd of April, we'll welcome the poet Marie Tussard, contributing her poem in French called La Paix, which means peace. Rather striking in its directness, Marie, through her poem, encourages us to create maximum positive value from our COVID-19 crises by changing our perspectives. Just after Marie, the exceptional Malik Boukherchi, again in French, will weave marvelous tapestries through wise tales and citations, including those from the American Indian cultures he loves so much. He touches us by his determination to inspire, and this marathonian of extremes, such as running in deserts or the Antarctic, also coaches us to overcome self-imposed limits. We wish him tremendous success in his future project of exchanging with people about our future world during a run from the Cape of South Africa's southern tip all the way up north to Algiers on the Mediterranean. And finally, on April 30th, we'll be graced by the former prima ballerina Kasumi Sanada-Ryu, interpreting an extract of Fernando Sor's Fantasy in C Minor, performed by Lou Marinoff from his Classical Voyages CD. Far more than just a talented, pretty dancer choreographer, Kasumi is also a passionately engaged dance professor dedicated to inspiring young people to follow their dreams. Still on the 30th, our finale presentation will be by the best-selling author, New York City University philosophy professor and guitarist Lou Marinoff himself, who will offer reflections on Fernando Sor, an engaged composer-guitarist from Spain during the tumultuous 19th century Napoleonic War period. Fernando was obliged to live and work as an exile in France and Russia, all the while searching for social justice and an enlightened Europe. Certain objectives he intuited from contact with great minds like von Goethe to Beethoven and Victor Hugo. Interestingly enough, Maestro Sor was also a deeply dedicated, brilliant, and human educator. We wish the Canadian-born professor Lou Marinoff enormous success in his upcoming historical novel, Fernando, the Beethoven of the Guitar, and we hope to see it very soon in French as well. At MUEC, we believe a key idea to creating a peace culture is that of interdependence, a concept also found in the South African term Ubuntu, as Club of Rome co-president Dr. Rompely recently underlined in an interview. This is one of the pillars of Club of Rome projects going forward, from what I understand, and what they call NC. MUEC would like to publicly express our support for their precious efforts for a better world. Our association MUEC stands for Musique Universelle Arc-en-Ciel in French, or Universal Rainbow Music in English. It uses rainbows to symbolize hope, but also as a concept for making what we call rainbow bridges between people from different cultural and religious backgrounds. We do this through what we call artistic conferences with speakers on topics like human rights and humanistic education, but always with moments of music or dance, poetry, painting, film, and other art or cultural forms. We hope to expand into workshops and education-related activities in the future. A last quick note about our April events. Every Friday, we'll put up at 8 p.m. Paris time a series of fairly short YouTube playlist videos here on the MUEC Facebook page. These will total between 20 and 25 minutes. For example, the next Facebook post you'll see here will be of Stéphane Orens and his musicians in the YouTube playlist I mentioned earlier. Our event is not interactive this year, but we hope our short, diversified mini events will be appreciated by our audience. Our variety of styles might surprise you, but hopefully you'll be delighted by the rainbow effect of diversity. By the way, April 30 is also the International Day of Jazz, as was collectively agreed upon by United Nations organization. The concept was created, however, in 2011 by the exceptional jazz man and human being Herbie Hancock, together with UNESCO, this essential UN agency touching on all topics such as education, cultural patrimony, and scientific endeavors and exchanges. In fact, the annual Jazz Day has been the primary inspiration for MUEC from our inception in 2017, so it's not surprising the Jazz Day mottos of human dignity and intercultural dialogue go hand in hand with our own MUEC values and objectives. Don't hesitate to leave your commentary, and also please tune in to Jazz Day Global on April 30th at jazzday.com and enjoy the all-star performances and events of Herbie Hancock and company, hashtag Jazz Day and hashtag Jazz Day 10. We hope our conference will contribute some inspirations to the vast subject of how we can tap our unlimited capacities to find solutions and create cultures of peace. We wish you very, very happy listening.